Hey friends, it's Ryan Brown. Today I wanted to unpack the brand new FARBAR contract that was released on November 1st. Now there was a lot of changes to it. I wanted to talk about the ones that pertain to financing and just unpack that for you so you can better understand when talking to your clients and your lenders. So let's go through it. What I would like to do is start off on section 5 under the extension of closing date. A couple things in here I wanted to unpack. So this is the paragraph where it talks about if there was a disclosure issue, there's an automatic extension to the closing date. So let's talk about it. In the event closing funds from the buyer's lender are not available at the closing date due to the Consumer Financing Protection Bureau closing disclosure delivery requirements, then the closing date shall be extended for such period of time necessary to satisfy the CFPB requirements, provided such period does not exceed, it used to be 10 days, now it is 7 days. They also added language in there that says, if paragraph 8B is checked, which is basically your financing contingency clause, that the loan approval has been obtained and the lender's underwriting is complete. So in order to get this automatic extension, you have to verify that the loan has been approved and that the lender's underwriting is complete. So that means the loan is basically clear to close except for the disclosure requirement. So why is this important? Well, prior to this change, some lenders would use this as like an automatic extension if their underwriting wasn't complete. Maybe they're waiting on documents. Maybe they got delayed in underwriting. Maybe they didn't qualify the borrower properly and a whole bunch of things came up that the underwriter wanted. So they would use this as a kind of a free get out of jail card and get them another 10 days on the contract. Well, that's no longer. So this is strictly for disclosure requirement. So let's just say the loan wasn't disclosed or they didn't disclose the CD in time or there's some delay or issue in their disclosures, then they could extend it. But they cannot extend it unless loan's approved and underwriting is complete. So that's very important. That was a really good change, I feel, in this new contract. Skipping through, if we go down to the financing contingency section, number 8, so they did change the term of 8A, which was the box that you check if it's a cash transaction. It used to say buyer will pay cash for the purchase of the property at closing. They changed that whole paragraph. Now it just says this is a cash transaction with no financing contingency. So does that necessarily mean that they're going to pay cash for the property and not even get a loan? No, it just means that there's no financing contingency on this contract. They cannot back out for anything related to a loan or financing. Skipping through to section 8B, this is your whole financing clause here. The contract is contingent upon within 30 days is going to be the blank loan approval period, which if any of you currently work with me, 30 days is completely absurd in my opinion. 15 really should be the max allowed. If you have any pre-approvals from other lenders that are requiring more than 15 days on a loan approval, please have them talk to another lender. There's no reason a lender needs 15 days for a loan approval. We're typically turning our loan approvals like in 7 days. With the new changes now, you might want to get a little extra time, but still 15 days is plenty. So the biggest change in this section is they changed the loan approval, the definition of loan approval. And the financing clause continues to say, buyer's mortgage broker lender having received an appraisal or alternate valuation of the property satisfactory to the lender, if either is required by the lender, which is sufficient to meet the terms required for the lender to provide financing for the buyer and proceed to closing. So what does this mean? It means your loan approval now includes the appraisal. The old contract basically said that you could get your loan approval, and then if the appraisal comes in after the loan approval and it affects the loan terms, you could still get out of the contract. So what would happen is the loan would be approved, everything looks good, they're proceeding on, and the day before closing the appraisal comes in, and the appraisal comes in low, and it now affected the loan terms, and the buyer would cancel right before closing. So that is no longer. Your loan approval period now includes the appraisal period as well. So there is no loan approval without the appraisal cleared. So let's just be clear on that. So you got to make sure whatever lender that you're working with, if they're going to say, okay, we're going to do a 10-day loan approval, or we're going to do a 15-day loan approval, you got to make sure that that appraisal is back within the 10 or that 15 days. Otherwise, the loan approval is null and void. It also says the buyer has to use good faith and diligent effort to obtain loan approval and meeting the financing terms within the loan approval period and thereafter to close the contract. Loan approval, which requires the buyer to sell a property, shall not be considered on the loan approval unless rider V is attached. So again, if the loan approval comes out and it states that it's contingent on the buyer selling another piece of property, then the loan approval is null and void. There is no loan approval. If there is a contingency on another sale of a property, you have to attach rider V. Moving on, it says buyer's failure to use good faith and diligent effort to obtain loan approval during the loan approval period shall be considered a default under terms of the contract. For purpose of this provision, diligent effort includes but is not limited to timely furnishing of documents and information required by the buyer's mortgage broker or lender, and they added, and paying for the appraisal and other fees and charges in connection with the buyer's application for financing. So they added paying for the appraisal and other fees. Why did they do that? They want to make sure that once you apply for the loan, that you're moving forward. You're using diligent and good faith effort. So if this client, say, is sitting back and saying, I'm going to wait till my inspections come back. I mean, let me just wait to order the appraisal. That could be default in regards to the contract. Once they sign this contract, they got to get moving. They got to make application within X days. They need to pay for the appraisal, pay for their inspections, pay for any fees that the lender's requiring. We don't charge any at our firm, but some companies do. So it's very important that that client moves forward and pays for those services and gets those moving. Moving on, it says buyer shall keep seller and broker informed about the status of the buyer's mortgage loan application. So what they did is they added now, buyer shall, upon written request, keep seller and broker fully informed on the status of the buyer's mortgage loan application, loan processing, appraisal, loan approval, including any property-related conditions of the loan approval. Buyer authorizes buyer's mortgage broker, lender, and closing agent to disclose such status and progress and release preliminary and final executed closing disclosures and settlement statements as appropriate and allowed to seller and broker. So in the previous contract, it gave just a blanket release. Now it says the buyer shall, upon written request, keep the seller and broker fully informed. So now there has to be a written request. So listing agents out there, make sure you are doing a written request to the buyer's agent and also the lender, saying that we are requesting you to keep us informed of the entire process. So that way you are now obligated to get those updates and you have a full release under this contract to get those updates. They added this paragraph. If within the loan approval period, buyer obtains loan approval, buyer shall notify seller of same in writing prior to the expiration of loan approval period. Or if buyer is unable to obtain loan approval within loan approval period, but buyer is satisfied with the buyer's ability to obtain loan approval and proceed to closing, buyer shall deliver written notice to seller confirming the same prior to the expiration of the loan approval period. What does this mean? The previous contracts stated promptly. They need to promptly deliver this news to the seller, whether they are proceeding through or they have been approved. The new contract requires you to provide that notice, not promptly, but prior to the expiration of the loan approval period. So it could be like the day before. Next section, if buyer is unable to obtain loan approval within the loan approval period or cannot timely meet the terms of the loan approval after the exercise of good faith and diligent effort, buyer may terminate the contract. So if we have a loan approval of 15 days and on day 14, the buyer just cannot get approved, he He can just terminate the contract. That is his right under the contract here. By delivering written notice of termination to seller prior to the expiration of loan approval period, provided buyer is not within default of other terms of the contract, buyer shall be refunded the deposit and thereby releasing the buyer and seller from all further obligations under this contract. So if he terminates the contract, he gets his full deposit back. Next section, if buyer fails to timely deliver written notice provided for paragraph 8B3 or 4 above to the seller prior to the expiration of loan approval period, then the buyer shall proceed forward with this contract as though paragraph 8A had been checked as of the effective date. What is paragraph 8A? That's your checkbox for cash contract. So basically, if you do not provide your loan approval within that period, the contract defaults this now to a cash contract. There's no contingency. So if your loan doesn't go through, and you had a 15-day contract, loan approval period, and you get denied on the 16th day, and you didn't terminate the contract, your deposit's gone. So it's very important, buyer's agents, to make sure that you're delivering that loan approval or the notice that they have been approved within that time frame. And then the next part of that, provided, however, the seller may elect to terminate the contract by delivering written notice of termination to buyer within 3 days after expiration, within 3 days after expiration of loan approval period. So what does that mean? Let's take the same scenario. You did not provide that loan approval. You are now deemed to be approved. It's now a cash contract, but the seller now has a 3-day window where they could send you a notice and cancel the contract on you because maybe they have a cash backup offer. So they might cancel the contract on you. You would get your deposit back, but you're gonna lose your house. You're gonna be out your appraisal, inspections, all that time, effort, money, and it's gonna be done. So the seller now has a 3-day window if you do not provide that loan approval. So again, make sure you're providing that loan approval. And the last section here that I'm gonna talk about is going to be section 6. Basically what it's talking about here is if your loan was approved and you did deliver notice that your loan was approved, and if you fail to close the contract, so say your loan's approved, then you fail to close the contract, the deposit shall be paid to the seller unless the failure to close is due to, number one, seller's default or inability to satisfy contingencies in the contract, or number two, property-related conditions of the loan approval, and then they added, specifically excluding the appraisal valuation, have not been met unless such conditions are waived by other provisions of the contract. In which event the buyer shall be refunded the deposit, thereby releasing buyer and seller from all further obligations of the contract. So I hope this was helpful for you. This is definitely not legal advice. I am not a lawyer. So make sure you're talking this over with a real estate attorney if you have any legal advice. But if you have any general questions about the sales contract and how it relates to financing, please reach out. I'd love to connect with you and chat with you about it. If you found this video useful, please share, subscribe, and comment below. Hope you're having a great day. We'll talk to you soon.